Yo, what's good? Big Z here. Sorry I missed the past couple uploads. I've just been super busy, but I'm back now. Gonna try to get back on the regular upload schedule. And anyway, today I'm gonna show you guys how to make this. So that is Zedd's remix of his own song called 365. And it's a really simple sounding drop, but there's a lot of cool things going on with the sound design and the sample selection and that really cool fill. So there's actually a lot to talk about here. So let's get right into it. As always, all the Serum presets and MIDI files will be linked down below. So let's start with the bass. The main bass is two layers. So most of the sound is coming from this one layer. The other layer is just kind of adding like a clicky attack sound to the top of the bass. So this layer by itself is from Serum, and it's just a pretty simple square bass. So in oscillator A, I have a square wave with one voice of unison because it's a bass right in the middle of the mix. I have mono check down here for voicing because I don't want the notes bleeding into each other. And then I have this envelope right here that's affecting the cutoff of the filter. And I'm not opening up the filter that much just because it's a super deep bass, so I want to keep it sounding pretty deep. Then in oscillator B, I just have a layer an octave up that's a pulse wave, and it has six voices of unison and some detune just to widen up the whole bass. Then over in the effects section, I just added a compressor and I also added a little bit of dimension expander just to make it a little wider. As for external processing on this layer, I added some ozone imager just to make it sound a little bit wider. And then after that, I have some multiband compression just controlling the sub frequencies a little bit more. That just helped it sit in the mix a lot better. So let's talk about this other layer that's layered on top of this bass. You can barely hear it in the mix, but it makes a big difference overall. So by itself, it just sounds like this. It's just a white noise attack sound. So this is literally just a ARP white noise in the noise oscillator in Serum. And then I have this envelope right here. And with this envelope, I'm just affecting the cutoff of this filter. Then I have this LFO over here that's in envelope mode. So every time a MIDI note plays, it re-triggers. And that is attached to the pitch of this white noise. So if I solo this layer on and off of the other bass, you'll be able to hear a subtle difference. But in the overall mix, it actually ends up making a pretty big difference in helping the whole bass cut through the mix. So before I talk about the drum samples and the fills, I'll talk about this other layer that comes in the second half of the drop really quick. It's just a layer an octave up from the original bass, just to keep things interesting in the second half of the drop. So this is just a pulse wave over here, or a half pulse wave, I don't know what you call it. And it has seven voices of unison with some detune. And the blend is down a little bit so it doesn't sound as wide. Then I just have the same shape envelope as the original bass affecting the cutoff of the filter. Then I have this sine wave in oscillator A with the level all the way down. And that's because I'm using FM synthesis from A just to help affect this pulse wave a little bit more. And then this one, I'm just cutting everything off below like 200 hertz to make room for the main bass. So let's talk about the drums, which are probably the coolest part of this whole track, just like the sample selection he uses and everything. So to remake this kick drum, I use three different layers. So it's really like a trap sounding kick drum. It's really punchy sounding. That's the bottom layer. Then I have this more like techno sounding, like mid-range kick drum. And this one I EQ'd like this, just to keep it in the mid-range here. So those two together sound like this. And then I added a third kick layer, which kind of sounds like some extra little white noise in the background, but really makes the kick sound more live and gives it some space in the mix. That layer by itself just sounds like this. Then this fill is super cool right here. I'll zoom in on it so you can see all the little parts of it. So Zedd kind of does this a lot with his fills, where you have like a main snare hit that's really producing the main rhythm of the whole fill, but then you have a lot of other percussion hits that are super low in volume underneath, and it gives it this really cool rhythm with these ghost notes and these ghost percussion notes that you can barely hear. So all these little percussion things are just hitting like every 16th note here. So you can barely hear them in the mix, they're so low, but they make a huge difference in adding some really cool rhythm to the fill. For the second half of the drop, he just adds like an open hi-hat and a clap, some pretty standard sounds, and a shaker loop down here too. So that's it for this one. I'll make sure to play the full remake again at the end of the video. For those that are wondering, I am still working on that sample pack for you guys, but it's gonna take me a while to finish it. So don't expect it that soon, but I'll for sure announce it on my channel when it's finished. Anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to follow me on Instagram and Spotify below. And other than that, I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.